This video describes the various types of sensors and where you would use them. We're used to the idea of switching off the lights when we leave a room. We might even dim the lights when there is plenty of daylight. With automatic systems, sensors are used which send a signal to the controller, instructing it to alter the lighting. The sensors can be mounted on the ceiling or walls, but also in the luminaires themselves. The commonest type of sensor is the movement detector. These mostly use passive infrared or PIR or microwaves to detect when somebody enters the room. It will then switch the lights on. As long as there is movement in the room, the lights will remain on. When people leave, the lights switch off automatically. Using movement detectors in corridors, stairwells, and bathrooms can save a lot of energy. Movement detectors are often fitted with lenses or shields to produce a narrow beam which can see down corridors and warehouse aisles. Alternatively, wide-angle beams are used which can detect movement anywhere nearby. An absence detector is similar, but when you enter a room, you have to physically switch the lights on. After a short period of time, if the sensor doesn't detect movement, the lights switch off automatically. They're particularly useful for meeting rooms. If there is a lot of daylight, a light sensor can dim the lights nearest the window or switch them off. These sensors contain a small photocell which responds to changes in illumination. Light sensors are often used in offices and factories with large windows. One last point to remember is that one sensor often controls several luminaires. For example, all the lights in a warehouse aisle, or a group of lights in an open plan office.